Acids and bases have been studied for a long time in chemical laboratories. We also have these substances around our home environment too. Acids are sour to the taste. If you think of something that tastes sour, most likely it's got some acids in it. Vitamin C, for example, is ascorbic acid. If you hang on to if you suck a vitamin C tablet, you'll notice that sour taste. Same thing is true of aspirin with acetyl salicylic acid. If you've ever had a chance to bite into rhubarb, oh my gosh, is it sour because of all the acids that are present. Well, the Arrhenius theory dealing with acids originated in the 1800s, and Arrhenius said that acids produce, in water, they produce H+. And I've put in parentheses a proton. Hydrogen, you know, is the very first element, has one proton, one electron. And if we take that electron away from it, then H+ is simply a bare proton. So we use those two symbols interchangeably, H+ and proton. Some examples of Arrhenius acids, hydrogen chloride, HCl, HNO3, notice that the hydrogen is usually written first. H2SO4 is sulfuric acid, that's battery acid, and H3PO4, phosphoric acid. All pretty common acids in the laboratory, and some of these we encounter in our home as well. Bases feel slippery to the touch. So if you're in the laboratory or an environment where you're working with something that might be a base, you'll notice a slippery, soapy feeling on your fingers. That's a good time to go over to the sink and wash the material off. Arrhenius said that bases produce OH, OH minus. That's the polyatomic ion hydroxide. Here are some classic examples of Arrhenius bases: sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. Just about any metal that you could think of over here, if it's got the hydroxide polyatomic ion with it, would be an Arrhenius base. Following Arrhenius's work, Bronsted came along with a little broader theory of acids and bases. Let's look at Bronsted now. In the Bronsted theory, acids are donors of protons, H+ ions, and bases accept H+ ions. So in an acid-base reaction, according to the Bronsted theory, all we really have is a transfer of a proton. Here's an example. If we add HCl to water in a reversible reaction, it can form H3O+ plus Cl-. Let's see if we can identify the Bronsted acid. And we'll use chlorine as the marker. And I notice that as I go from the left to the right, HCl has given up its proton. That means that HCl is a Bronsted acid. Well, it had to give it up to something. There's only one other thing, so this must be the Bronsted base. And indeed, if I use oxygen as sort of a label now to keep track of the number of hydrogens there, as I go to the right-hand side, I see that H2O has picked up a proton. So indeed, H2O was the base. Because this is a reversible reaction, it can go the opposite direction, and that means that we have Bronsted acids and bases over on the right-hand side. H3O+, as it comes back to the left, would give up a proton. It must be the Bronsted acid. Cl- accepts a proton, so it must be the base in the reverse reaction. And sometimes we couple these two, the acid and the base that are formed, and call them a conjugate acid-base pair. That would be HCl and C- in the reaction proceeding to the right. Going to the left, the Bronsted acid, H3O+, and its conjugate base, H2O. Let's look at two more equations that are Bronsted acid-base reactions. It's an important skill that we'd like you to have to be able to identify the acids and bases on both sides of the equation. Here's a common product around the home, ammonia water. It's a mixture of ammonia and water. In a reversible reaction, it can form ammonium hydroxide. And ammonia water makes a good cleaner, especially for windows and screens, probably because of that OH minus that's formed over there. It's good at attacking greases and films. Well, let's identify the Bronsted acids and bases. Let's use nitrogen as sort of a label or to help us track what happens. Here there are three hydrogens associated with the nitrogen. Over here, there are four. That means that NH3 has accepted a proton. It must be the base. Water must be the acid then. And let's see, here there are two hydrogens associated with the oxygen. Over on the right-hand side, only one. So indeed, water is an acid this time. Over on the right-hand side, NH4 is the Bronsted acid. And OH minus is the Bronsted base. Here's an equation that I haven't labeled. Let's see if we can figure it out. This is an ionic reaction, as the one it was above. We've shown the presence of ions. HS minus. Over there, it's S2 minus. Well, the sulfur compound has given up a proton. It's donated a proton. This must be the Bronsted acid. Water must be the Bronsted base. It must be accepting the proton. And indeed, we see that it's picked up that proton as it goes to the right. Let's see if we can identify the acids and acid and base on the right-hand side. Well, there's only one of these two compounds that has protons. And that's the H3O plus. This must be the acid. And this must be the base.